Topic is quantization of angular momentum and de-Brogle concept. Okay, right. Now there is a condition for stationary state. There is a condition for stationary state. There is a condition for orbit 2 pi r equal to n lambda. So the condition for stationary state n pathina, the circumference of circular orbit is equal to the integral multiple by de-Brogle wavelength. So say around the nucleus we have electron in circular path, isn't it? So we had a discussion, we have only permitted orbits. The electron was not found in all the imaginary orbits around the nucleus. Okay, the orbits where electrons are found are generally called as permitted orbits. So the permitted orbit ku or condition da 2 pi r equal to n lambda, which means in the orbit order circumference 2 pi r, electron wavelength order multiple r, only that orbit can have electron. So 2 pi r equal to n lambda order meaning adha. Okay, the circumference of circular orbit or the circular orbit whose circumference 2 pi r is equal to integral multiple of de-Brogle wavelength of electron only can carry electron. Adha. Okay, right. But now so I have written the condition of stationary state. Okay, right. Now formula la right hand side la we have lambda, isn't it? So I'm going to substitute in the place of lambda h by mv. I'm going to substitute in the place of lambda because you know that lambda equal to h divided by mv, which is nothing but de-Brogle relation. Now stationary state or condition la I'm going to substitute de-Brogle relation. Now the equation becomes 2 pi r equal to n h by mv. Now I'm going to rearrange this. I'm going to bring m and v on left side, 2 pi on the right denominator கொண்டு போயிருக்கோம். So after rearrangement, so I'm getting a relation MVR. பாருங்க R அப்படியே வச்சுட்டு MV வரும்போது MVR ஆயிடும். MVR ஆயிடும் இல்லையா? The 2 pi வந்து denominator கொண்டு போயிருக்கோம் right hand side. So I'm getting this relation MVR equal to NH divided by 2 pi ஒரு relation வருது இல்லையா? So this relation already we have discussed under Bohr's theory, discuss பண்ணியிருக்கோம் இல்லையா? As a third point, I think you remember. Okay. This is a condition for stationary state. This is the condition for stationary state, isn't it? The stationary, that is the orbit whose angular momentum is equal to nh by 2 pi only can have electron. Okay, right. So that we start with the de-Brogle relation and substitute pani, then finally Bohr's condition reach pannalaya. So that, which means that de-Brogle relation and Bohr's theories are coinciding with each other. Okay, na solra point purida quantum condition stationary state oda condition formula first elvi irukken, and the formula la de-Brogle relation lambda oda value substitute pannirken. Appo in the sense here I am applying de-Brogle relation, so ultimately I am getting a Bohr's stationary orbit oda condition reach pandrom. Appo so de-Brogle relation la aarambicha we are getting Bohr's stationary state oda condition reach pannirken liya. Appo so that, so that proves that both these concepts are agreeing with each other. Okay, so this was the topic, quantization of angular momentum and de-Brogle concept. Okay, right. So now this can be asked in a different way. Prove that de-Brogle concept and Bohr's theory are agreeing with each other. Okay, this may be another way of another way how the question can be asked for this particular topic. Okay, question, and I repeat the question. Prove that de-Brogle theory or de-Brogle relation and Bohr's theory are agreeing with each other. Okay, right. So next page number 42 la you are given some diagrams, isn't it? So already we had a discussion that not only the light, even particles such as proton, neutron, electron, atom, molecule are all are having the particle as well as wave nature, isn't it? Suppose if the electron has wave nature, if the electron has wave nature, when it revolves around the nucleus, it will be moving around the nucleus in just like this. So look at this diagram. So this is nothing but the stationary state or circular orbit where the electron moves around. Now you can see a wave kind of arrangement is clear. So this is the way how the electron wave moves in the circular orbit around the nucleus. Okay, right. The first one I have written, not the first type of movement on the not allowed, the second only allowed. So what is the difference between these two diagrams? Okay, first one, this is the starting point of the electron wave. Now the electron moves in form of wave in the circular path, and when it comes over here, it is not coinciding with the starting point. But look at this one. This is the starting point. So after the movement, after completing the stationary orbit, again that electron wave is coinciding with starting point. Okay, so that so only the second type of movement, wave form of electron is allowed. Second type of diagram, second type of movement only allowed for electron, which means that if an electron starts at a particular point, when it moves around the nucleus in a form of wave, then it should come and join with the starting point. In a starting point, join agla, in the starting point, join up. So this kind of movement only allowed for electron. Okay, that's what this is, the allowed movement. This is not allowed. Okay, then look at the other set of diagrams. Okay, so look at this diagram. This is the diagrammatic representation of wave movement of electron, which is placed in the third cell. So I have written n is equal to 3, isn't it? So n is equal to 3, 3 on the cell number. So this is the diagrammatic representation how the electron moves around the nucleus in form of waves, troughs, and you have crust and troughs, isn't it? The upper portion on the we call it as crust, lower portion on the we call it as trough, isn't it? But now when an electron is present in third cell, third stationary orbit, when it moves around nucleus in form of wave, probably it will form three number of crust and three number of troughs, isn't it? Now when you look at this, there are three crusts as well as three troughs, isn't it? I think you are able to follow what I am trying to say. Okay, look at the second diagram. So there are four number of crusts and troughs. So which means this last diagram represents the wave movement of electron, which is present in the fourth stationary state, fourth cell. Okay, likewise, we are given the electron nature, where the electron is present in nature of electron, where the electron is present in fifth stationary and sixth stationary orbit also, which means that if the electron is in the fifth stationary state, probably it may form six number of crusts and six number of troughs. Okay, so this is about the wave nature of electron, the way how the electron is moving around the nucleus, and which kind of movement of electron is allowed, which is not allowed. Okay, so the electron after revolving around the nucleus, the electron when it joins in the starting point, that kind of movement only allowed. Okay, right. So this is what about the wave nature of electron. Okay, right. So Purindha, any doubt about this topic? Right. So next, let us go to the next topic. The next topic is nothing but an experiment, Davison and Germer experiment. An experiment which is used to prove the wave nature of electron. Now already discussed for now, de-Brogle has proved, or de-Brogle has said that electron, proton, atom, molecule, all these substances are having both particle character and wave character, isn't it? To prove the particle character, there are many experiments even for wave character also. Now what we are going to discuss is nothing but an experiment which is used to prove the wave nature of electron. The experiment is called as Davison and Germer experiment, or important experiment. Ajaz, I will explain with a simple diagram. The diagram, Anna, if you want, you can just draw it for reference, okay? Right, so now this one is nothing but hot tungsten filament. Hot tungsten filament. Davison experiment, what you are going to prove? You are going to prove the wave nature of electron. You are going to prove wave nature of electron. Right, so as I said, the first, this part is nothing but hot condition called tungsten filament. Tungsten, when you heat tungsten filament, you know the tungsten filament on the will release electrons. So here we use tungsten filament as a source of electron. Tungsten flow metal enna use pandrom as a source of electron. Okay, appa now the electrons which are produced from the tungsten filament will be allowed to pass through a slit, because the filament emits electrons in different direction to make the electron to travel in a single direction. Electron or single direction la travel pandruka enna pandrom emit our electron vandu we allowed to pass through a slit. I think you know what is mean by slit. Okay, so the electron which comes out from the slit is what we called as electron beam. So this is nothing but beam of electron. Now the beam of electron is accelerated by a high positive potential. So the electron beam enna pandrom, by applying a positively charged potential we accelerate. In the sense that you know very well that electron is having negative charge, isn't it? So negatively charged electron, if you apply a positive potential, so what will happen is that positive potential will increase the speed of the negatively charged electron, so that the electron is getting accelerated. So this point you can note it as accelerated beam of electron. Accelerated beam of electron. That acceleration, increasing speed of electron, can be done with the help of applying a positive field, positive magnetic or electric field. Okay, right. But now the accelerated beam of electron, it is allowed to fall over a single large nickel crystal. So this is nothing but nickel crystal, a single large size nickel crystal. Okay, so that the beam of electron is allowed to fall on the surface of nickel crystal. Okay, right. Now what will happen is, now the electrons are getting scattered in different direction. From the surface la single beam will have, so now after falling over the surface you can see it is getting scattered in different direction. Okay, right. Now the scattered electrons on we have to collect on a photographic plate. So this is nothing but photographic plate. Photographic plate is nothing but a film, negative sound only, photographic film, negative, now they call it as photographic plate. Okay, right. Now when this electron falls over the photographic plate, it will cause some change over that. Okay, so once the experiment is completed, so we have to develop this photographic plate, and the photographic plate develop panni we have to observe it. Okay, so while observing that photographic plate, after development it is seen like this. It is seen that the photographic plate is containing so many number of concentric circles like this. Okay, which is called as diffraction pattern pair. What is this called as? Diffraction pattern. So photographic plate on the after developing, it gives a diffraction pattern like this. The diffraction pattern consists of several concentric circles. Okay, right. Now same kind of diffraction pattern, same type of diffraction pattern on the already obtained in another experiment, Bragg's experiment. There was a scientist called Bragg. He performed an experiment called as Bragg's experiment. What for he did Bragg's experiment? Now to prove the wave nature of X-ray. To prove the nature of X-ray, he want to know what is the nature of X-ray. So for that he did an experiment. Well, that experiment is what we called as Bragg's experiment. In his experiment, he got the same type of pattern, diffraction pattern, which consists of several concentric circles. From the diffraction pattern, he proved that X-rays are behaving like a wave. Okay, right. Now even for electron also, here we are allowing electron, we are doing an experiment with electron, we are getting the same diffraction pattern for electron also. We are getting a diffraction pattern similar to X-ray for electron also, isn't it? From that we can conclude that like X-ray, even electron also has a wave nature. Okay, so if electron or a diffraction pattern and X-ray or a diffraction pattern or a compare panni, we prove like X-ray, electron also behaves like a wave nu prove pandrom. Okay, so this is what we call it as Davison and Germer experiment. Okay, a simple ah dhaan kuduthirpan textbook la konja I have explained little bit elaborate. Okay, puridha? Shall I repeat that experiment again? A beam of electron vandu produce, the experiment oda objective enna na, we are going to prove that electron is having wave nature. Okay, right. Now first what we do is we take a tungsten filament and we heat it. Tungsten, hot tungsten filament generally emits electrons in different direction. The electrons which are emitted from the filament is allowed to pass through a slit to make it as a beam of electron. Then the beam of electron is accelerated by applying a positive potential. Then finally the accelerated beam of electron one, it is allowed to fall on a single large nickel crystal. Now what will happen is, from the surface of the nickel crystal, the electrons are getting diffracted, or scattered. The scattered or diffracted electron one, it is allowed to fall over a photographic plate. This photographic plate, after developing, it gives a diffraction pattern like this, which consists of, this pattern consists of several concentric circles. These circles what you call as concentric circles. Okay, right. Similar type of experiment was already performed by the scientist Bragg, what is called as Bragg's experiment. He did that experiment for proving the nature of X-ray. Okay, from his experiment, in Bragg's experiment also, he got a diffraction pattern like this. From that, he proved that X-rays are behaving like a wave, isn't it? So for electron, we are getting a pattern which is similar to X-ray, so that we can conclude, like X-ray, even electron also behaves like a wave. So now, okay, right. So that's what about Davison and Germer's experiment. Okay.